Nuclear power is my favorite choice to produce electricity in Factorio's endgame. In this video, I will explain how to build a reactor and how to avoid common pitfalls you might come across. It is crucial to conduct thorough testing of your nuclear power plant once it's ready for production. Let's start with the most important part, the nuclear reactor. Inside a fuel cell and a controlled nuclear fission chain reaction produces heat for exactly 200 seconds. Unlike other entities in the game that burn fuel, the chain reaction cannot be stopped until the fuel cell is depleted, regardless of the load or temperature. At the end of the fission process, a used-up uranium fuel cell will be generated. Used-up cells must be removed at some point. A single nuclear reactor will output heat equivalent to 40 megawatts of energy. That's good, but not amazing. What really makes nuclear energy shine is the so-called neighbor bonus. The reactor receives an additional 40 megawatts of energy for each neighboring reactor. To receive the bonus, each reactor must be directly adjacent to each other and both must be operational. Unfortunately, you cannot have four reactors adjacent to each other as one side of the reactor must be accessible for the insertion and removal of fuel cells. For this reason, a two-row reactor layout is most effective. A nuclear reactor heats up to a maximum temperature of 999 degrees. Once the maximum temperature is reached, additional energy is wasted. Heat spreads through other reactors, heat pipes, and into heat exchangers. However, it will never dissipate into the environment and is therefore stored until it is converted to steam and eventually electricity. Heat pipes are used to transfer heat from reactors to heat exchangers. Each tile has a temperature drop, limiting the amount of energy that can spread through the pipe in a given time. This is why heat pipes should only be as long as necessary. Two rows of heat pipes have a slightly higher energy throughput than a single row. Heat exchangers convert heat and water into steam, equivalent to 10 megawatts of energy. Just like reactors, heat exchangers and heat pipes rise in temperature and therefore act as a buffer of energy. Heat exchangers won't produce steam until reaching 500 degrees. The required water and the amount of steam generated are 103 per second, respectively. This is a major pitfall because depending on the number of heat exchangers in a row, a bottleneck in the water or steam pipes must be avoided. I can't stress this enough. Most flawed reactor designs I've seen struggle because of water or steam shortage. Don't use more than 10 heat exchangers per fluid system to avoid problems. Steam turbines transform 60 steam per second into 5.82 megawatts of electricity. Don't build more than 18 turbines per pipe system because the same bottleneck limitations apply here. Therefore, 18 turbines to 10 heat exchangers is a preferred ratio. Let's talk about best practices. Always build a nuclear power plant next to a body of water. The amount of water needed cannot reasonably be transported by train. For example, 8 reactors generate 1.12 gigawatts of electricity and consume 11,500 water per second. That's half a fluid wagon per second. It's also possible to build offshore with landfill. This way, offshore pumps can be placed perfectly. Using the ratios mentioned earlier of 10 heat exchangers and 18 turbines per pipe system, you have a lot of flexibility when it comes to pipe length. For example, this reactor has blocks of turbines far away from its heat exchangers without throughput issues. If you don't use my recommendations, calculate if throughput isn't limited depending on your pipe length. Make sure you have free space next to the reactor for nuclear refueling. I prefer using logistic bots with a requester chest and an active provider chest, but it's also fine to just use belts. If you want to make sure that your reactors can always be refilled, even during power outage, use a dedicated electric network just to power inserters. A single solar panel and one accumulator are sufficient. There is no point in using storage tanks to store excess steam. Reactors, heat pipes and heat exchangers already act as energy buffers storing heat. Don't mess with your UPS rate by adding unnecessary entities that require expensive fluid calculations. Also, do not use circuit networks to control fuel cell refill behavior. I know it's fun to do so, but uranium is abundant in Factorio. There's no point whatsoever in trying to save fuel cells. Even in a 900 science per minute desert death world, with turrets firing uranium ammo and trains using nuclear fuel, the amount of total uranium needed is very low. If you've finished your nuclear power plant, go test it in either sandbox mode or use slash editor to get infinity chests, infinity pipes and electric energy interfaces. An electric energy interface can draw the maximum amount of power possible. Supply your exchangers with either water pumps or infinity pipes. insert fuel cells and check if the reactor is continuously providing the maximum amount of electrical energy. Production of nuclear fuel cells, uranium processing and kovarex enrichment will be worth another video. If you watch this in the future, it may already be available here. If not, watch this video next. Thank you.